Hi, I'm Simone, and I'm going to be showing you MIT Learn, which aggregates all of MIT's online learning offerings and is designed to support learners in every step of their learning journey. Let's dive in. We're at the MIT Learn website. As we visit the homepage, we can see featured courses from MIT, Open Learning, Professional Education, and Sloan Executive Education. All of these offerings are combined within MIT Learn. We can browse by topic if you have a topic of interest that you want to look into further. And you can also see testimonials and MIT stories and events that might interest you as a learner. From MIT Learn, there's different ways to explore the offerings. You could use our search functionality, or you can browse and explore, for example, by topic. So if I go to our topic page, I'm interested in science and math. Biology is there too. Let's see this page, and all of the science and math offerings are incorporated within this landing page, and you can also search within the landing page. And for the biology topic, we have following functionality for topics and departments at MIT. And if I click follow, I'll receive notifications when new courses and resources are available for the biology topic in this example. So if I follow, and it shows that I am following this topic. I've been to this site before. I have an account on MIT Learn, as you can see here. And today I am interested in learning a bit more about MIT Learn's biology offerings. We have a variety of different options for filtering courses, programs, and learning materials where I can see videos and podcasts that are available. I'm interested in courses and let's see, maybe certificate or certificate of completion. Yeah, academic content from MIT's academic curriculum. Still seems like there are quite a bit of offerings here. Let's see, molecular biology, introductory biology. Let's see if I ask Tim. So AskTIM is one of MIT Learn's AI features where I can get more feedback about which course to take based on what it knows about me and the inputs that I give it. Let's see, I'm getting up to speed in biology, introductory biology. Let's see if there's anything about molecular biology. All right, I recognize some of these courses from the search results. Maybe this molecular biology part one, DNA replication and repair. I can see different information about the course, when it was taught, instructors, other resources from the same topic. So I've bookmarked the molecular biology part one course. I want to see if this is the right course for me. I'm gonna ask our AskTIM syllabus AI tool a little bit more about this course. I'll open this up. I'm curious about if there are any prerequisites for this course. Great, it's told me about a specific course that is a prerequisite, Introduction to Biology, The Secret of Life. So that's good to know. If I haven't taken that already, I will need to before this course. And I'm also curious, I'm going to ask the syllabus AI what the main takeaways are from this course. Great, those are helpful takeaways, and I have a better understanding that this is the right course for me. So I've decided to take that molecular biology part one course that was recommended to me from MIT Learn. I'm now taking the course and I'm watching a video on DNA structure. We have a new AI feature for courses called AskTIM, and it's a tutor AI feature where you can ask questions about different assets within a course, specifically for videos and for problems within a course. So for this video, we have our Ask Tim about this video button. Let's hear a little bit more in the course.
Thus, we can see that the sugars and phosphate groups make up the DNA backbone. The carbon numbering is key to describing the directionality of the DNA strand, 5' to 3'. Looking within the sugars, there is an intrinsic orientation difference between the two strands. On the top strand, you can see that the 5' carbon of each sugar is on the left, and the 3' carbon is on the right. The opposite is true for the bottom strand.
So I have some questions about this. I'm going to ask our tutor AI. I open up this feature, and there's a few different tools at the top: chat, flashcards, and summary. For chat, I want to know a little bit more about 5' and 3'. Great, that definitely gives me a bit more information that was helpful. Within AskTIM for a video, we also have flashcards, questions, and answers where you can quiz yourself to make sure you've absorbed the content in the video. So you can click here for the answer for each question and then proceed through the flashcards. And then this tab here also provides a high-level summary of the video as well. So for our tutor AI, as I mentioned, we also have that functionality available in the context of problems in the course. In this part, we have a problem on DNA helicase. If I scroll down here, this is a multiple choice question, and I have some questions that I'd like to ask our AI tutor. What is the structure of a polypeptide chain? Great, and the idea here is that our tutor AI will help you as you're working through the solution, but not provide an immediate answer and to guide you as a TA would in a course. I have a follow-up question that I'd like to ask. What does side chain mean for an amino acid? So it gives me some information about that, but also some things to think about further as I'm exploring and working through this problem. So that was MIT Learn, lifelong learning the MIT way.